Here's a tip to give you some extra distance by improving the attack angle. If you like this video, like and subscribe for loads more free videos. Right, we all want to hit that ball further, and I'm going to show you today with the use of the TrackMan how changing your angle of attack will have a huge effect on how much distance you get on that golf ball. Now, we know club speed is really important for getting distance, and we want to get center of the strike, but also the attack angle, especially for the driver, is really key. So what I see with a lot of club golfers is generally they're hitting very down on the golf ball, maybe 2 or 3 or 4 degrees down with the driver, and that creates quite a low launch angle generally, and with a lot of spin on it. So the ball will tend to sort of plateau, spin up in the air, and doesn't go very far when it hits the ground because it hasn't got the correct launch characteristics. So with the better player, the tall players, and a more advanced, longer hitters, they tend to hit more upwards. They create more of this upward contact through impact, almost hitting 1, 2, 3 degrees up. The likes of Bubba Watsons and Rory McIlroys might be hitting 3, 4, 5 degrees upwards. That gives them a higher launch with a lower spin rate, and that's what we're trying to look for. Now, there's things that we can do to do this. Like I talked about in one of the earlier videos, we can keep the ball up the left heel and create a nice tilt in the shoulder, so you feel like your right shoulder's a little bit lower so that you can touch the right knee at setup. If you're not quite tilted enough, you can see I put my right hand out and I can't touch my right knee, okay? So we're gonna keep the ball forward, we're gonna keep the tilt in the shoulders. But what I'm gonna do first is just show you a normal shot, but I'm gonna hit a little bit more downwards on this one, okay? So I'm gonna hit my normal shot, but I'm gonna hit a little bit more downwards on it as I hit it. Okay, so decent shot, wasn't my best strike, 102 miles per hour speed, I'm keeping this quite natural, 1.4 degrees down, and our total 272. So decent distance, but that was me hitting more downwards on it. I'm gonna try to keep the speed roughly about the same. Sometimes when you get a bit more shallow, you find your speed will get a little bit higher. So this time, I'm gonna put the ball more inside my left heel, and I get a bit more tilt so I can touch my right knee at setup. I'm gonna try to put the same swing in it, and just try to feel it from the setup characteristics. I'm gonna get a bit more shallow as I hit this shot. So huge difference in the launch there straight away. Hopefully you'll see that on there. Picked up a couple of degrees more mile per hour of speed. And you see the attack angle's gone from 1.4 degrees down to 0.3 up. Now look at the difference there. Nearly 20 yards further in the distance because of how I change my angle of attack. So the speed only a couple of miles per hour more than the one before, but a 20 yard gain nigh on in the distance. So how we create the attack angle is huge for the driver. Nice straight golf shot, plenty of launch, and a nice low spin rate as well. So that's why then the ball goes so much further. So when you go play this week, keep the ball up inside the left heel, make sure it's far enough forward, it sits inside the left heel, and remember that feeling of the tilt of the shoulders. So when you take your setup, put your right hand out, if you can touch the middle of your right knee, then reset, and you can see then I've got a nice tilt behind the ball, and that's the key then for creating that angle of attack, that shallower angle attack, which is going to give us a lot more power. So when you go to the range or you go to practice this week and you go to the golf course, give that a go, set those angles and watch your distance increase. Give that a go and let me know how you get off.